you're ready to ship out your orders, creating the label or labels you need is an easy process in ShipStation. We'll be going over both how to create one label and labels in a batch. When you log into ShipStation, the first thing you need to do is just click on Orders, and then click on the order that you want to ship. In the order sidebar on this right-hand side, you'll notice that you have all of the information you need to go ahead and ship this order. Now, the buyer requested UPS Ground, and you can see the service, the package type, confirmation, and insurance have already been filled in. In addition, we do already have the weight and the size of the package. To make sure that everything's okay with this order and I don't have anything that I need to address, what I'm going to do is just click on Get Rate. You can see that it successfully returned a rate of $40.28, so now I'm ready to go ahead and create the label. I have a couple of different ways I can do that, the first of which is just by this Create Label button right up here. The other is this Create Label button. These are both here to make sure that whether or not you use the order sidebar, you have the ability to create a label quickly and easily. In addition, you also have the ability to use your order detail pop-up, which is available by simply clicking on the order number for the order you wish to view. In this case, you have the same information as your order sidebar, so you can still choose your shipping information, look at all of the other order information, and then go ahead and click Create Label. All of these three Create Label buttons do the same thing, so don't worry about which one you should or should not be using. When we go ahead and ship a single label, you'll notice that we give you a confirmation again of all of your shipping settings and how much it costs. In this screen, you can also choose a scheduled ship date, and then when you're ready, go ahead and click Create Label. The first time that you go ahead and do this, what will happen is we will show you a Print Label screen. This screen will go ahead and give you the different ways by which you can print your label. Preview in a browser, download that PDF, print via Google Cloud Print, or print via SyncStation. Both of these two options, once you have them set up, will allow you to print directly to your printer. In this case, we'll go ahead and just download the PDF, and you can see that on the bottom hand of my screen, it's already been downloaded, so I can go ahead and save this to my computer and print it out whenever I want. Now, let's go ahead and create a bunch of labels. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and close this download bar, and I'm going to go ahead and close this order detail pop-up for the label I just created. Creating multiple labels at a time is a little bit different, and there are a couple of different ways you can do it. The first of which is by simply selecting the orders that you want to ship and clicking the Create Labels button. The other way, and what I'm going to show you now, is by using our concept of open label batches. So what I'm going to do is, for these orders right here, I'm going to go ahead and change these so that their shipping configuration is by UPS Ground, and the package type is just package. And here I'm actually going to select delivery confirmation, which is actually more expensive. So now that I've done that, I'm going to click update selected orders. And now you can see that my rate column has no rate anymore, so that means I have to go up and click get rates. And you can see that I have my total rate for these orders of $65.15. Now that I have these all ready to go, I still have more labels that I want to create. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click this Add to Batch up here, and I can click Create New Batch. This warning is letting me know that another user is in here and going ahead and processing some orders. Now, what I can do is I can choose to move them or I can exclude them. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and move them into my new open batch. So all of those are now in my new open batch. Now what I can do is I can select the rest of these orders right here. And to easily select multiple orders, all I'm doing is clicking the first one, holding down the shift button on my keyboard, and clicking the last one. So you can use your keyboard commands to either navigate through or select multiple orders. Now in this case, you can see that it says, well, last time you wanted to go ahead and change these to UPS Ground, Package, and Delivery. Do you want to do the same thing? It's going to remember what you did. In this case, I don't. I don't want these to have delivery confirmation. I want them to only have online confirmation. So I'm going to go ahead and update these orders. Again, my rate column cleared out a little bit, so I just need to make sure that I go ahead and click Get Rates. I've got my rates over again, and so now I can add them back to this batch. Now, you're going to notice that I do have the ability to create a new batch. You can have up to 5 open batches per user at any given time. So just keep that in mind in case you have a different kind of process where you don't want to have a single batch, but maybe you want to split them up because they're going into different boxes or something. Now, in this case, I want to show you the other way that you can add these to the batch, and it's just by clicking and dragging. And so now you can see I have all 8 of those orders in this batch. The batch screen looks a lot like it did on the orders grid. Basically, it's the same thing, except instead of creating labels, you have process batch. So since I've already made sure that all of these have the correct settings on the orders grid, I'm going to go ahead and just click process batch. We'll go ahead and validate everything. It is warning me that delivery is an additional $2, and I selected that on purpose, so I know that, and so I'm good to go. So all I'm going to do is just click continue. And now it's going to tell me exactly how much this is going to be. Just like I did on a single label, I can choose what my ship date's going to be. And then as soon as I'm done with that, I'm going to click create labels. As you can see, the label creation process is pretty quick as it's already done. So at this point, I have the ability to go ahead and print my labels, my packing slips, my other documents, including an order summary, pick list, and shipment manifest. And I can go ahead and when I'm done with it, I can archive my batch. Now, in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click Print Labels. It's going to bring up that same print document screen that I had before because I haven't chosen a default. Since in the future I'm going to go ahead and want to just download that PDF, I'm just going to select this button right down here and click Download PDF. Now, since I did select a default, keep in mind that in the future, if I ever wanted to have this pop-up show up again, all I would need to do is long click, basically click and hold for a half second on the button, to have this window show up again. So now I'm just going to click download a PDF like I have before, and my labels are already downloaded. Once I've gone ahead and printed these, all I have to do is click this checkbox to mark this batch as printed, and then I can go ahead and archive it if I want. That basically just makes sure that I know that everything's been done with this batch, and I don't have to worry about doing anything with it anymore. Once you finish processing your batch and you close that modal window, we'll give you a couple of different options, which you can see here. There are ways of making this process even faster by setting up that Google Cloud Print or SyncStation that I talked about earlier. You can always check out our help site for articles on how to set up those features for your account. For more videos on the features of ShipStation, check out our site at shipstation.com/videos.